Soccer fans, Soccer Sam fans, who's here live in Rochester, New York, the Black and Blue War Memorial, where today the Rochester Lancers take on the Harrisburg Heat. Possible playoff berth, huge game. I have the beautiful Brooke with me. Welcome to the broadcast.
Thank you for having me, Soccer Sam.
This is huge. Joe Giuliano was suspended for comments I made in Baltimore about a referee and his family and his mom. And unfortunately, Joe will not be here. I tried to save his job. I wanted to take the heat for it. I tried sending audio of the broadcast. I sent blood samples, all these things, but they would not buy into it. And Joe is now suspended for two games.
He's on a family vacation, Sam.
Oh, Joe's on a family vacation. Well, tonight, the Harrisburg Heat come to town. You know, last time we played the Heat, we destroyed them in Harrisburg.
21-12.
It was a good game, though. I mean, Harrisburg came back. Yeah. I mean, Harrisburg only one win this year. They're struggling, but a great, great team. We'll see what happens today. But first year of the Lancers, we made the playoffs. We have not made the playoffs in two seasons. This is our fourth season. We make the playoffs tonight.
We're ready.
We're going to play Syracuse, round one,
yep.
Probably. And then Baltimore. In Baltimore, we need to beat the Baltimore Blast. We've never beaten them.
We can do it.
You think we can do it?
We can do it.
Well, you know, Valentine's Day, this is going to be a huge match. Kisses for everyone. Well, Hershey kisses, right?
Of course.
Hey, wait, the producer Johnny's talking to me right now. It's time for the kiss cam.
No. Sam, there will be a kiss cam tonight, though, for the duration of the game.
There will be a kiss cam.
Yes.
You know, Brooke is a college intern.
College intern with the Rochester Lancers for marketing.
So what school you go to?
Genesee Community College.
I almost went there.
I
couldn't get out of high school, though, but I was going to go there. Listen, we're going to be back. My buddy Dom Vieira from Dunkin' Donuts, we call him Dunkin' Dom. Him and I are going to be doing the broadcast because Joe Giuliano is suspended. What do you think? Do you think the Mohican Warrior is going to score some goals today, Elliot Fowski?
I think he's ready. I think he's going to do very well today.
I mean, he's a midfielder, defender, but Elliot Fowski, he's got the thing, you know, the mohawk.
Oh, yeah. It's definitely intimidating to the other players.
And then Mauricio Salas from Brazil last night. Mauricio Salas, very upset, scored a three-pointer. They called it back. They said no goal. Got elbowed in the face. He looks at the referee and says, do you think I was born with this black eye? The referee says, just keep on playing. And the referee, you see, there was a part of the game last night, you fans that watched last night's game in Baltimore, the referee's contacts fell out, and you could see it throughout the building. His contacts were like this thick. He used a shoehorn to put his contacts on.
Yes, he obviously works at Foot Locker. He's not a ref.
He wasn't a real referee. We'll be back here in Rochester having a little fun here. You're going to enjoy this match. The Rochester Lancers take on the Harrisburg Heat live right here from the Black and Blue War Memorial in Rochester, New York. Thanks, beautiful Brooke.
Thank you, Sam.
Coming up, first quarter action here at the Blue Cross Arena, brought to you by the Dick-Eyed family of dealerships.
You that. Let's hear it loud. Let's hear it proud. Get loud and crazy for your Rochester Lancers.
Dom Vieira from Dunkin' Donuts. Dunkin' Dom, you and I are filling in. I'm filling in for Joe Giuliano, and you're filling in for Elliot Fowski, who is on the field tonight playing.
He is fantastic. Great to see Elliot back. You felt the energy at the introduction when he was introduced. People were clapping even before the name. So it gives the team a lift, and just really fantastic to see Elliott back on the field.
Mauricio Salas with the ball right now. Mauricio did not score last night in Baltimore. Kind of disappointed. He had a three-pointer, was called back by the referees, but it gets the first shot of the game and a shot and almost a goal there by Joey Tavernese, our third leading scorer of the Lancers. Fans, it's been a snowstorm here in Rochester, New York. Roads have been closed. Snow warning is in effect. But still, an amazing turnout tonight. Thank you so much. On Valentine's Day afternoon match, Dom, when they do the kiss cam, you and I got to do a little thing, a little puckering up. What do you think?
On the cheek only.
All right, buddy.
Okay, I like it, but not like that.
Dom, one of the owners of the Lancers, helping me out here. We've been doing this kind of stuff in our heads for years together. Now we get to actually do it for real. The Lancers need to win this game to make the playoffs for their second year in their history. Year one, they made the playoffs with Billy Andrecki as coach, and hopefully this year, tonight, they beat Harrisburg and get a playoff berth into the first ever MASL playoffs.
Exactly. We fully expect to win. Just have fun with it, and hopefully the guys enjoy it and feed off the fans and the crowd and enjoy the moment. You have to enjoy the moment.
Nice hit off the boards, and that was Ken Fultz with a shot there, and Joey Capinos, one half of the Wonder Twins, just picks it up nice, gently, nice ball to the boards to Pupu Perez. They call him the bull, the mule. He's so tough on the ball. And Enrique from Costa Rica with the ball. He's about to take a left-footed shot, decides not to. Goes all the way back to the midfield line to Brad Veneno. Veneno back to the snake, Jake the Snake Schindler. They call him Earthquake Jake in some parts. And a little foul there by Enrique. Enrique's a little guy, Dom, but he plays tough.
Yeah, that was, I mean, chintzy foul, but it's okay. Henri is.
Did you say sissy foul?
Chintzy.
Oh, chintzy. I think you can't say sissy. I don't think you can say sissy in the air anymore, Tom. It's not politically correct anymore.
Our producer told us what we can and cannot say.
Yeah, so. Our producer. Speaking of sissies, our producer, John Catalano, helping us through this somehow.
Yeah.
He doesn't know what he's doing in that booth right now.
Yeah, he's doing a great job.
Yeah.
You know, but no, they're, you know, a lot of energy so far. Really great. Expect the first quarter to be a little tired, a little heavy legs. Expected to come on, so, but a lot of energy right now. Mauricio has the ball and he's trying to feed into the corner, so you know, he has Perez, so that's great.
Yeah, Pupu Perez, nice little try there from Salas. That right there is Val Teixeira.
Teixeira from Lisbon.
He's from Portugal. He's also good friends with Salas. And
yes.
Val just takes down, it looks like Steven Bassel.
I think they just went in a clumsy foul.
They both went down.
Yes.
And unfortunately, I cannot see what player that is.
Who is that? I can't tell either.
All right, fans, looks down. Like they're doing a timeout here. It looks like Steven Stefano. No, it's not. It's, all right.
Hey, Sam, can you hear me?
Yes, it's J.P. Reyes, I believe.
It is J.P. Reyes down right now. He looks like he's okay.
Yes, just a knock. Teixeira is also okay. He's from Lisbon, so he's probably used to running in the streets and having people hit him. So.
All right, guys are down right now. So listen, last night the Lancers lost 11-0 to Baltimore. We need to win this game tonight to get the guys back into it. Five goals, one did go in. J.P. Rask gets a nice round of applause from the fans here. And he looks like he's okay. J.P. from Ecuador took a hard knock there to Val Teixeira. They call him Teixeira. He's the captain from Portugal. We are getting correspondence. Mary, one of our producers, is checking in to see if we can hear her. We can't hear her, Mary. So hopefully Mary can hear us.
Yes.
Two Lancer players down right now, and they're back up. Stefano Steven Bassel off the boards to the bull, the mule, Pupu Perez from Cuba. Nice play there by Steven Stefano Bassel. No, there's Jeremy J.O. Ortiz to Mauricio Salas, who's got a big bruise under his eye. Got a nice elbow last night in Baltimore and got real upset that the ref did not call anything. But time to just move on. Look who makes his appearance, the Mohican Warrior.
Elliott Fowski.
He's on the field right now here in Rochester. Tim Mell with the ball right now, long ball into the corner. Nice little ball there to Ken Fultz. Fultz looks around. Looking to go back right now to Zach Seal. Seal goes over to Cash. Cash with the ball right now. A little off the boards there. Look at the Warriors. First touch on the ball, and the fans react. The Warrior is so tough. He played in Harrisburg a couple weeks ago we played Harrisburg just to see if he was ready, and no symptoms, no concussion symptoms after the match. He did a great job. Enrique steals the ball there, taken down.
Gotta be a blue card.
Blue card.
Penalty shot, should be.
And it should be a penalty shot.
Should be a PK, it is. At the top of the box, top of the yellow.
Enrique from Portugal. Here's an angle of that, and he tries to come back. Enrique says, "You're not playing those games. I play futsal in Costa Rica, man."
Great effort.
Nice job there. And it is number three, Zach Sal, with the blue card and the 2 minute. And producer John Catalano, I have Mary from Fickle blowing up my other extension here. Not sure what's going on, but it looks like Mauricio Salas from Brazil, the living, look at him. He needs a score here. Was shot out last night in Baltimore. It's a Labatt's blue card given to Zach Sal. Here's Salas. In the goal.
Great shot.
2 point goal. Rochester, Harrisburg, Baltimore, and Syracuse are testing the multi point scoring, and Mauricio Salas gets a 2 point goal down.
That was a great touch. The goalie hesitated. Mauricio just picked the corner, and a great shot. Nice, calm. Very good. Great start for the Lancers. Just what we needed. Now let's just get going and keep on going.
At the 11:17 mark of the game, Mauricio Salas from Brazil
he just waited the goalie and he put it into the corner. Very good, Mauricio.
Zach Mel kind of came out down a little. I think he should have came out a little quicker, the goalkeeper for Harrisburg. Great player, though. Tim Mel should have came out a little sooner.
Definitely. He made it easy for Mauricio to basically pick the corner. But we'll take it. We'll take it. 2-0.
Now the teams are full strength. Both teams, five guys on the pitch, and their goalkeepers making it six. Dunkin' Donuts gets 1 pound of coffee, goes the food link for every goal we score here at the Black and Blue War Memorial. And great stuff from Dunkin' Donuts, my favorite coffee and donuts. Here we go. Val Teixeira with a high shot there. He's the captain. He controls the defense, the offense. He's up and down. He's everywhere. And he goes back to goalkeeper Timmy Mel. Tim's a great player. A lot of pressure on him this year. A lot of injuries. Yeah, whoa, what a chance there. And I think that was Cash up and over. And went over Capinos. Capinos jumped a little early. And that could have been a goal there for the Harrisburg Heat. And Heat comes in now with a little tough there. And here, the pride and joy of Buffalo, New York right now. Gary Bouton there. Gary Bouton's been nursing a shoulder injury. Playing tough, tries to feed the Warrior. The Warrior goes back to Bouton. Bouton looks around and goes all the way back to Jamie Capinos, who has a blistering left-footed shot. We haven't seen much of it this season, and hopefully Jamie gets into the action with a shot. And this could be it. Off the boards, trying to feed Hoxie, and the ball bounced wrong. A nice try there by Jamie Capinos, trying to feed Hoxie. And look at Enrique. Oh, a little fast move there from Hoxie, and Enrique got excited. Elliott taken down late there by the Harrisburg defender. But nice play there down by Enrique.
Phenomenal effort by Enrique. Both times he went in and he won both balls. Great effort so far by Enrique. Caused a penalty shot, you know, a foul, and he won some of those little things in the game that result in goals, and that was phenomenal by Enrique. Good stuff.
And that was Mauricio Salas with a shot, and Jeremy Ortiz kind of got a little body into it and got the goalkeeper, Tim out of the way, Tim Mel out of the way. Right now, I'm kind of impressed with Tyler Whitmer from Harrisburg. Great defender, kind of getting everybody's faces up and down, doing a great job. Harrisburg's got a great team. Young team coming together. But John Wilsbach, the owner, is doing a great job for this organization and being a great partner in the new Major Arena Soccer League. Dom, you know, they talk about the NFL, the NBA, and all these leagues. It took them 20 years to become halfway decent. We're into our first season, and this league is just so tight.
It is, and the quality is getting better and better back from year one. You know, I compare this team a little bit to ours, less Mauricio and Dougie, obviously, the star factor year one. But a lot of these guys are probably first-year players who never played indoor soccer, and it's hard to get used to playing indoor soccer. So
yeah, it's adjustment. It's a faster game. You know, I've said this for years. You have to be an intelligent player to play soccer to begin with. But soccer, you have to have that special speed from the brain to the foot, indoor soccer. It's a little different outdoor. You can still be talented, but your brain doesn't have to go to your foot that quickly at times. You got more space to think. Indoor, no time to think at all. You got to quickly kind of react. Like right now, Dave Cash was just trying to go around Jeremy Ortiz, and Ortiz got the ball, but here comes Harrisburg again with a shot off the boards, and there's Jamie Campinos to Ortiz. Ortiz gives it to Tavernese and looks for Salas, and Salas is going to come off. And the Warrior, it looks like the Mohican Warrior and Elliot Fowski are switching. So it looks like Elliot is playing forward. Here's the Elliot to Tavernese. Tavernese looks for Jeremy Ortiz. You love Jeremy Ortiz as a player.
I do. Again, work rate, energy. You can't teach work rate. You know, you can teach, positioning and what have you, but you, that inner drive to make somebody work, that is extremely difficult to do. And both him and Elliot have that. You'll see a big, huge difference now with Elliot back in that midfield, creating turnovers and getting to the ball first, beating people to the corner. It just makes a big, huge difference when you have a player, and, you know, he leads by example. And I think it's a huge, huge asset to the Lancers.
And the Lancers, it looks like Elliot and Mauricio are going to play short shifts, or Elliot's going to play some short shifts, get back into it. It's a long story. I'll tell you about it later on in the match. But here comes Gary Boughton with a nice through ball to Andrew Hoxie, the big smooth, and nice defensive play there by number three, Zach Sell, for the Harrisburg Heat. Harrisburg's an up-and-coming team in this league, the MASL. 22 there in the corner there. That's Chris Hall looking around, spinning around there. Hall trying to go around and takes down defender Steven Stefano Basso. Steve lost 6 pounds, is on the special training regimen. Looks so much leaner out there, Dom.
He does. You know, he did a great job right there. He put his body between the forward and the ball. And he had no choice, either foul him or just let him get the ball. So great play by Basso.
We are in the Lancers Broadcast Network, going coast to coast around the world on the MISL Broadcast, Time Warner Sports, and of course, Fickell 93.3 FM, where they play everything, including the Lancers. Oh, look at Enrique. Enrique does it.
Great job, Enrique.
The referee doesn't call it.
He's on fire.
Enrique helped create that ball. And look at Perez. Pupu Perez does the Cuban Macarena, the dance from Cuba.
Is that an ole? What is it in Cuban? I don't know if it's ole.
I think it's arriba, but I'm not sure.
Great work by Enrique once again. The effort, the get-go. He caused a turnover. Phenomenal play by Enrique.
Enrique, I mean, I'm surprised the ref didn't call that. He kind of got underneath the goalkeeper, but gets the ball to Pupu Perez. Perez says, hey, you didn't have the ball. I'm giving it to Perez in the goal, and he does the celebration, the dance from Cuba. Just got here. He just came to America just weeks ago. We're not sure how he got here, if it was a boat or raft, but he is here, and we're happy he's here, Dom.
Again, great play. Good non-call. I don't think there was a foul whatsoever. The goalie dropped the ball, and Enrique had the quickness and the attitude to go get it. And it happened to go to Perez, and he put it in the net. Great play.
Looks like Harrisburg calls a timeout. I think Tim Mel and the Harrisburg fans would feel different about that. I think Enrique got the goalie a little bit, knocked him off the ball. It's usually not allowed. They let it slide. It's okay. It's to the Lancers' benefit. But right now, the Lancers are up 4-0. First goal by Mauricio Salas on a penalty kick, and now Pupu Perez with a second goal. 4-0 Lancers. Enrique with both assists.
Sure, sure. As long as you're paying me, Sam, I'm biased towards the Lancers. So.
Wait a minute, I have to pay you? I got to pay you, Catalano. Catalano was supposed to do the Grammys. At the last minute, he said, you know what, I got a better gig at the Blue Cross Arena. He does the Amherst, the Nighthawks, Roller Derby, and, of course, the Lancers. And then the other team, they catch butterflies. What's that team called? They chase the butterflies, the Nighthawks.
The Nighthawks.
Yeah.
Speaking of scary, in between the anthems, a big something came up on the screen. I don't know what it was, but it scared the heck out of me. I can't explain what it was. But
really?
Yeah, I think Johnny knows.
We have to see what that is maybe at halftime.
I don't know. We'll have to figure that out. But there was a foul there in the corner. Who was it, Tavernese?
Tavernese took out Casey Lenker. Lenker's looks like he's okay, though.
He's okay.
body into the boards. Kind of tough one there. Off the boards, Baltimore's number. Baltimore.
Did that the was game
last
Sam.
Night. That was last night. Yeah, that's Harrisburg. Dave Cash. I like Dave Cash. I think he's a great, great player. Up and down.
Yeah.
A lot of skill. Number five for Harrisburg. I say he's the player to watch for them.
Great last name too.
Yes.
Can he sing?
John,
oh, that was John.
Johnny Cash.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Joey Tavernese right now in the corner, taking out his man. He's going to go off the boards. No, it looks like a nice defensive move there by Casey Lenker. Casey, great job there. And here comes Harrisburg, number four. Ken Fultz off the boards there. Nobody there for Harrisburg and Tavernese. He takes the ball and just kicks it all the way down to Tim Mell. Dom.
Yeah, great defensively. Just regroup and, you know, get back behind the ball. And they're doing great so far. A lot more energy than what I thought we would have. So. I expect a little lethargic in the beginning of the game from, you know, they get back at, 7 o'clock in the morning. So they're doing very good. That's probably why you see the short shifts. Probably expect a little longer maybe in the second quarter, third quarter, and fourth quarter, what have you. They're doing great so far, though.
7 a.m. we arrived at Total Sports Experience where we left our cars for our bus. And Doug said, you guys got 2 hours of sleep. And I'll see you bright and early at the Blue Cross Arena for kick around. So
tough night.
Yeah, and it's tough to sleep on the bus when you lose, especially when you're shut out. Baltimore, Ed Hale, Danny Kelly, Kevin Healy, what an organization they put together. But we probably will end up playing Syracuse round one of the playoffs, and we'll end up playing Baltimore in the final of the division, the Eastern Division final in Baltimore. And we'll see when that announcement comes in officially. There's some dates right now, 11th or 13th in Baltimore, and we most likely will play Baltimore here on the 5th. Here comes Poo Poo Perez, tries to go around the defender there, and here's the Mohican Warrior off the boards, wide open is Enrique. What a goal by Enrique from his roommate, his buddy, his friend, the man that brought him here, the Mohican Warrior, Elliot Fauske.
Exactly what we were saying earlier in the game. This is what Elliot Fauske brings to the Rochester Lancers. That attitude where I'm getting the ball, I'm going to beat you to the corner, never give up, you know, having the presence of mind to hit it off the board. And again, Enrique so far is on fire. He's playing phenomenal. Phenomenal, Enrique. Good job.
One goal, two assists for Enrique from Costa Rica. And Enrique, what a play there. Elliot reads it well. See, you got to hit the boards just right. Elliot gets the ball, and he's like, I'm just going to gently hit it off the boards right to my friend Enrique. You don't have to kill it. You got to play indoor soccer with your brain, nice and gentle. And Enrique says, I'm right here, my friend, right here. So in year one of the Lancers, Elliot needed someone to help him with his mohawk. And Enrique, we honestly kept him on the team because he helped Elliot with the mohawk. And then Enrique kept on improving. And so now he's gets us a start here tonight against the Harrisburg Heat.
Well, if things don't work out in soccer, he can be a hairstylist.
Yes, Enrique Salon.
Enrique Salon. We do men and women.
all right, here we go. The Mohican Warrior is like on fire. Look at that mohawk. You know, Dom, I went to Jamaica once and I had my back hairs done like that. I had a nice mohawk in my back hairs, and my wife wasn't happy with it, but it looked pretty hot.
Our producer can relate to that, I believe.
John Catalano, our producer, my good friend who's been doing this for years, makes Joe Giuliano, Elliot Fauske look and sound good every match. And tonight, he's going to do his best with us, Dom. I've never done play-by-play on TV and radio, but we're going to go to break now here on the Lancers Broadcast Network, worldwide, coast to coast, baby.
See ya.
The Lancers lead 6-0. We are back here live, Rochester, New York. The Rochester Lancers are up on the Harrisburg Heat, first quarter, 6-0. I'm with Duncan Dom Vieira, my partner from Dunkin' Donuts, my good friend. Former Canadian national team player, almost, right, Dom? Last cut because of the knee.
Grade seven. I almost made the Canadian national team.
You're a good player, though. Here goes Mauricio Salas with a header. Tries to go over goalkeeper Timmy Mell. Nice try there from Mauricio Salas.
Great ball.
Right now, Enrique from Costa Rica is the first half player of the game so far, the Blue Hawk player of the game.
Oh, hands down, Enrique, the energy that he's playing with. Like, really, really good. And again, Elliot has brought an energy and just I'm getting their attitude. Again, Enrique right there, that he called a foul, but yeah, gave him a blue card for that. That wasn't really a blue card, but We'll take it.
He's upset. Enrique's like, I don't deserve a blue card. He wants a green card, Dom. He wants to stay in this country. I told him just to get married. But now he said, they give me a blue card. I want a green card. But he's going out 2 minutes, Enrique. Enrique's got to learn, though, that and anybody listening that plays soccer at any level, you never see a referee change his mind when you argue with him. No. Why do you argue, especially Absolutely. If you're a professional athlete? Why argue? Just go on the bench, serve the penalty, come out in 2 minutes.
Exactly. He's not going to change his mind. So if anything, you maybe try to plant a seed. But let the coach do that. He plants a seed for the next foul. But he went down. Whether from this angle, I couldn't tell if his feet were up or studs were up or what have you. It looked clean from here, but it's a foul. It's a blue card. We'll kill this off and go from there.
Lancers with the penalty killing unit of Jamie Capino's Elliot Fowski, which I'm surprised, Jake Schindler and Steven Stefano Basso in front of goalkeeper Joey Capino's. Yeah. Here's the Mohican Warrior. He's out there doing a penalty kill, and here comes Jamie Capino's with the speed, one of the fastest players on our team with an amazing left foot. If this kid just gets some confidence to shoot, he could be something special. I tell him he's got Brian Harris type abilities, and everyone out there knows Brian Harris from the Missouri Comets, one of the best players in the league. Jamie Capino's has those natural skills. Taken down there right there by...
Great work by Teixeira, took him down.
Val Teixeira took him down. The Portuguese star, Mike Moran, taking pictures here. Down, look at, they're putting us on Bookface. How you doing, Michael? Michael Moran, covering us here, doing a lot of things. We got a great group of people helping us behind the scenes here at the Blue Cross Arena in Rochester, New York. If you're listening, you're part of a different team in this league. You got to be proud of the MASL. All the games on Go Live Sports. All the games.
They're on. They switch it up now. A different line. You got Boughton and Vino and the same defenders, Basso. And so they switched up their two forwards with Vino and now Hoxie's out there for the throw to try to get us into the corner. So far it's pretty good. 54 seconds left on the PK.
They're talking about the next home game here Thursday night. This Thursday night, February 19th, 7 o'clock. A lot of kids home from school. Come and celebrate the break. 7 o'clock action, $10 tickets. We're giving away flashlights, which, Dom, we could use a flashlight right here. Here's Brad Bonino right now with a breakaway. Bonino tries to go around. Val Teixeira can't do it. And there, out of nowhere, is Hoxie. Andrew Hoxie. They call him the Big Smooth. They call him Mustache Mania. Has a 1970 mustache that he got from one of his childhood stars when he was watching VHS videos as a kid. And here comes Gary Boughton, the pride and joy of Buffalo, New York, with the ball right now. Goes over to Stephen Basso. The Lancers are kind of killing this this two-minute power play here. 17 seconds left, and Enrique still in the box. He's back. He's in there. Still blaming the referee for a bad call. Nice try there by the Harrisburg Heat. And Jake the Snake Schindler intercepts. Here we go. Off the board. Their shot and goal. Here, the Heat's first goal of the match by number 22, Chris Hall. Shorthanded there on the penalty killing unit. Chris Hall with the Heat's first goal. The Lancers up 6-2 here in Rochester, New York, with seconds left in the first quarter.
I think it had just expired, the penalty, and basically a little bounce in the middle went off Basso and went right, great shot. It went right to him, and he put it in the corner.
Nice job by Chris Hall. Capinos couldn't do anything on that. Great goal and a great, great player there. Chris Hall for the Harrisburg Heat.
Great shot.
Great opportunity. You got to take opportunities. We said this last night in Baltimore. They just don't miss every opportunity. We seem to miss a lot of easy ones. Once these easy ones start going in, I think we'll be a different team here, the Rochester Lancers. And here comes Chris Hall again with a lot of momentum, a lot of energy, and a lot of confidence after what he just did. And a nice shot there from the far corner from the Harrisburg player that I didn't get to see his number there, unfortunately. Here comes Jeremy Ortiz looking for Poo Poo Perez. Perez going one-on-one with goalkeeper Tim Mel, and Mel picks it up and says, hey, I got it, no problem here. Now Enrique with another steal, goes to Poo Poo Perez. Perez, right foot, left foot, taken down, and Enrique does his magic. Enrique tries for the shot and the expire. The time is up. Salas is saying, hey, baby, you should have passed me the ball. At the end of the first quarter, the Rochester Lancers are leading the Harrisburg Heat 6-2 live here in Rochester, New York with Dom Vieira. We'll be right back on the Lancers Broadcast Network.
Lucky fans can win a...
And now, let's go down the field for some second quarter action. Brought to you by the Dick Eye Family
back
here of Dealerships.
At the beautiful, beautiful Blue Cross Arena in Rochester, New York, with the Lancer Dancers. We're in the Eye Family of Dealerships Broadcast Center, brought to you by Blue Rock Energy. Cypress here, live with Dom Vieira from Dunkin' Donuts, my buddy, my partner. So far, 6-2, the Lancers up. Nice goals in the first quarter of play. We're now at the start of the second quarter. 6-2, Lancers up from the Harrisburg Heat.
So far, so good. Great effort in the first quarter. Great energy. Tell you the truth, a lot more than what I thought. I thought they'd be more laid back in the first quarter and gradually build. So far, so good, and just keep going.
Tim Mell, the goalkeeper for Harrisburg with the ball right now, puts it down for distributions, looking for the nice feet. Looks over to his defender, says, hey, man, here you go. Take the ball and do something with it. Here comes Harrisburg looking for Val to Sarah. He can't leave Val wide open. What a shot. What a goal. And it might have been a three-pointer.
No.
Leaving Val wide open like that, you just can't do that. And Harrisburg scores a great, great goal from their captain, Portuguese player Val to Sarah.
You know, he was left alone and on his left foot, on a strong foot. So you can't give a player that of that quality. He's 37 years old, but he can still finish the ball. So great pass across. And he was able to put it away. It is not a three-pointer, it's a two-pointer, so that's good.
Capinos had a chance to look at that. I wasn't expecting a shot like that, but Val does not mess around. One of the best shots in the league. What a great Harrisburg player. And does magic for them. Kind of controls the offense and defense. He's everywhere. He's a great player. Right now, Harrisburg, now with four points, 6-4. Lancers are up in the second quarter of play. 13 minutes into the game here, into this quarter. Here comes Jamie Capinos there. I want to see Jamie Basso score some goals here. Here's Enrique doing his magic, looking for Perez, and it goes right over to Tim Mell, goalkeeper for the Harrisburg Heat. And here comes Mr. Cash, no relation to Johnny Cash, number 5, Dave Cash with the ball right now, going back to Bradley Kernstetter, if I'm saying his right name right. I'm sorry, Bradley, if I'm not. A little spin there from the goal scorer earlier in the match. Chris Hall, number 22, looks around off the boards, comes all the way back to the midfield line for the Heat. Harrisburg Heat, great, great team, great, great organization. First year struggling in the MASL, a lot of learning pains, like Dom Vera said earlier. We had the same issue year one, finding great players that were adjusting to outdoor soccer, and what a chance there for Chris Hall right in front of the net. Could have easily tapped that in, didn't go in the way he wanted, didn't bounce off the boards the way he wanted, a little fast off the boards, Dom.
Very impressed with Chris Hall so far. You know, you can tell they have the skill set. You know, they just have to learn the indoor game. They're very skillful, very good. They have a couple really good players. And again, learning curve, they will be much better next year than they are right now. And they're playing fine today. They're playing fine.
Nice hit there by Ryan Roars. He wears number 9 for the Harrisburg Heat. I'm not sure what's on his jersey. We'll check that out in a second here.
Yeah, we can't tell either.
We are far up here at the Blue Cross Arena. Not the best view for me, for a guy my age, but Joe Giuliano, our normal broadcaster, who is on a special family assignment, Valentine's Day assignment. Here comes Val, the captain, over the ball right now. Direct kick here for the Harrisburg Heat. Val is going to go upper corner, looked for the upper 90 there. And Capinos looked like he had it, but didn't react. Nice chance there for the Harrisburg Heat. And they go all the way back to goalkeeper Tim Mell, if you will. And then they just keep on looking for Val. Bounces off over into the bench, into the Harrisburg bench. It'll be Rochester ball here, the Lancers ball down.
You can tell. Every time they get the ball, they look for number 7, Val Teixeira. And they look for him. He distributes. He was very close to scoring that restart goal right there. He's just a good player, sure-footed. Great left foot.
You know, Dom, you mentioned something about different names. I know that every time Elliot and Joe are on the broadcast, they mention Dominic Cicluna's name differently. Dominic Cicluna, now the coach for the Las Vegas Legend, undefeated as a coach. They won again last night against San Diego, won last week against Baltimore. Congratulations to my favorite mayor, Mayor Cohen, and the new coach, Dominic Cicluna.
Yeah, Las Vegas is playing very well. Like you say, they were able to beat Baltimore last year, and that does so much for your confidence. You know, it does so much. And you know, they were able to beat San Diego. Oh, great goal by Hoxie.
I mean, you can't teach that, ladies and gentlemen. Andrew Hoxie just kind of was juggling the ball like you're playing in your garage, just juggling the ball around the Harrisburg Heat defenders, taps it in. That's why they call him the Big Smooth, the best feat in the business for a big guy. The Lancers go up 8-4, 11-minute mark of the second quarter, Dom.
Yes, exactly. We always tell kids to turn with the ball, how to turn. You know, get your hips turned is a perfect example of Andrew just getting the ball, great juggling, and able to turn his hips to put that ball in the corner. Great play by Andrew Hoxie.
The Lancers go up 8-4. The Big Smooth, Andrew Hoxie, look at this dance right now. Just dancing around. It's like, hey, you know, it's just like, you guys don't bother me. He throws out the signed autograph ball to the fans. The Big Smooth, Andrew Hoxie. Hopefully we'll find out who assisted that, Dom. I missed the assist on that one, but definitely Hoxie with a very pretty goal.
He was, yeah. Maybe when he scores, he's going to play some Tom Jones. That's pretty smooth, isn't it, Tom Jones?
Yeah, Tom Jones. And Elliot, he's a big fan of this guy. I don't remember his name. Ron something from the 70s.
I don't know about him. Not even going there, Sam.
But that's why he has the mustache. It's kind of a 70s thing that he pays tribute to someone he met in Los Angeles in the movie business. They're calling the Hoxie goal unassisted. You can't assist a goal like that.
No.
When you give a guy and he's juggling around four or five players and tucks it in the corner of the net, you don't give an assist. You give him all the credit, and that's what they did here. Thanks to John Catalano, our producer. He calls the shots. We'll decide who gets the assist and who doesn't here. Here comes Harrisburg. Val brings down Capinos. Could have just lifted it over him. Decides to go back, and Basso dove. No, I'm sorry. That was J.P. Reyes dove in front. Up and over, and I'm worried about Capinos. Looks like he's struggling a little bit with his left leg.
Left leg or right leg?
Right, you know what? I think you're right. It's his right leg.
Right thigh or knee.
Something. He's holding it. He was holding it earlier. Still a nice ball to Salas. Salas heads it. Tried to give the little flick on to Jeremy Ortiz. Doesn't work the way he wants it. And here comes the Harrisburg Heat.
Bring the heat, baby.
You know, the Baltimore Blast, their cheerleaders or dance team, they're called the Heat. They give out a lot of heat over there in Baltimore. Blistering cold, but once the heat came out, the dance team, the Heat, the building just warmed right up last night in Baltimore.
I bet it did, Sammy.
Little shout out to Veronica. That's just a name I made up, Tom. Here we go. Here comes the Heat, one-on-one. Nice chance there for Bradley Curse Letter. We'll call him just Bradley K. Nice try there, Bradley. Little high. You got to finish those babies. That's what we're talking about, the indoor-outdoor experience. You finish your opportunities. That's the difference between Missouri, Baltimore, San Diego, Las Vegas. They get the chances. They finish them. And Syracuse, you know, seems to have players with the indoor experience that do that. Salas Hoxie have it for us. We're getting it, though. A lot of the guys in the forwards are kind of understanding the game better. You need to not rush the ball. You have to think fast, but with love. You have to. The ball's an egg. You have to be gentle with the ball off the boards, and some of these guys just kill a little too hard.
And that's easier said than done. Having composure on the ball, it's easier said than done.
Nice back heel, Andrew Hoxie to Gary Boughton. Gary Boughton slammed into the boards, struggling with his shoulder. And J.P. Reyes comes all the way back. What speed by Reyes, and saves the day from the Harrisburg Heat player with the breakaway there. They're leaving Val wide open. They can't leave Val. How do you say it in Portuguese?
Val Teixeira.
Teixeira in Portuguese. They're leaving him wide open there. You saw Val there with a chance there to just knock it in. Capinos getting his body in front of the ball. And now Capinos with a nice throw to Enrique. Enrique's looking for the pass to Perez. Doesn't work out. And here comes the Mohican Warrior. The ref calls no push on that. I'm surprised.
Push.
And here comes Pupu Perez with a breakaway, looking to slow it down a little bit, waiting for some changes. And here comes Perez with a pullback shot, comes back. Salas is waiting for the rebound off the boards. And here comes Jake the Snake Schindler. They call him Earthquake Shake. Jake with the ball right now, back to Boo Boo Perez. Perez in the corner, looking around. He sees Salas, left-footed shot. Oh, just wide off the post. Salas, what a shot from the Brazilian, Mauricio Salas.
Yeah, Mauricio loves that ball on the end board, and he likes to poke it into that far corner. That was not very far away. Not very far away from getting back in the net.
Here comes Joey Tavernese, and back to Jeremy Ortiz. Ortiz, again, left-footed shot. What a save by Mel. Tim Mel, nice save on Salas' three-pointer.
Corner kick, I believe. Yes.
And they're calling a corner kick here. Congratulations there to Tim Mell with a, not congratulations, but an amazing save. He was like extended, complete body. The referee saying, no, we decided it's going to be goalkeeper distribution. And here we go, goalkeeper distribution from Tim Mell for the Harrisburg Heat over to number 22 goal scorer, Chris Hall, for the Heat. The score now is 8-4. Lancers up. It's 8 minutes into the second quarter. Nice ball from Salas to Hoxie. Hoxie looks to give back to Boughton. Little miscue there, but Salas with a hard one around the goalkeeper. Over and around. That's a goalkeeper.
I think
nightmare.
It went behind him. It might have gone behind him.
Goalkeeper Tim Mell's like, what just happened there?
He got a haircut.
Salas has the hardest shot in maybe all of soccer, but definitely in the MASL. One of the best players in this league. And Joey Capinos gets robbed there from Harrisburg's Chris Hall, their goal scorer. Goes back to Cash. Cash looks way over to number three, Sal. Zach Sal over. And now with the ball will be J.P. Reyes. From here, J.P. Reyes looks like Rich Randall.
You know what? You're right.
I thought it was Rich. I'm thinking, wait a minute. You know, we're all doing somebody else's job tonight. Is Rich playing for J.P.? But no, Rich Randall, our president, is running game ops and taking care of the sponsors in the suites and doing his magic. Him and Kayla Clark Kent work hard every game, satisfying these great fans of ours with Ashley King, Patty Powers, Mikey Moran. Just doing their magic every game. And here we go. Mauricio Salas from Brazil had a chance there with a nice back heel from Pupu Perez. Didn't work out the way they wanted it. Ortiz with the ball, a little too hard off of it. It's still in play. That's
still
the
play.
Beauty of keeping the glass up. Here comes Basso, open net off the boards. Steven Stefano Basso promised me 3 goals tonight. Steven with a 3-point chance there off the off the corner post there. The goalie's best friend is what they call it in soccer. Here comes Pupu Perez, a little magic. Tries to lift it through the legs. Nutmeg. It looks like Pupu Perez with a nutmeg. The Cuban, no dance.
Where's
there.
The dance? Where's the dance?
You know, I think he says, hey, that was a little lucky on my part. I'm not going to
rub it in.
Rub it in a little bit. That's a classy move by Pupu Perez. The Lancers go up 10-4, 6-minute mark. The fans do the dance. The Lancer dance after every goal. Here we go. Here's the replay. Salas with the ball. Salas will get the assist on this. Looks around. Goes to Perez. Perez is going to backheel them Salas instead. He kind of nutmegs Val Teixeira and goalkeeper Timmy Mell, and it goes in. Lancers up 10-4, Dom.
He did a great job posting up, almost like a basketball post, and he was able to squeeze it between Teixeira's legs. So it's good. 10-4, and they're on a roll, and everything's going great.
They're showing the fans, which is Dom's wife there, Paula Vieira, and some of our fans, Luis Ribeiro from Dunkin' Donuts. And
You gotta get those two guys for Kiss Cam.
Yeah, we'll get those two guys for Kiss Cam if you're watching online. If you're listening on the radio broadcast there, we're just having some fun. Soccer San Fan 2 is there filling in for the suspended Joe Giuliano. I made comments about a referee in Baltimore. Joe got suspended. The commissioner of the league did not want to believe it was me that said it. Right now, the Rochester Lancers are up 10-4 live here in Rochester. We'll be right back here on the Lancers Broadcast Network. We're back here live in Rochester, New York. The Rochester Lancers up 10-4 against the Harrisburg Heat. Lancer kisses out there. The Lancer dancers, they announced that the Lancer dancers are going to give out kisses, and everybody's like on their feet, like wives are looking like, she better not kiss you, honey. Well, they're Hershey kisses. We got them at Hershey Park when we were there for the Lancer game against the Harrisburg Heat a few weeks ago. Great place to visit, Hershey Park, on your next trip to watch the Harrisburg Heat in that great Farm Show Arena. Lancers back, Salas with a chance right now, up and over. It should be a
Lancers corner kick,
and they call a goalkeeper distribution again. Great goals here. But, you know, Dom, we talked about in the break about last night, San Diego loses to Vegas 8-5. Turlock beat Sacramento 9-5. And Saltillo lost to Texas 13-7 in some great matches today. A little time out here for the referees. Not sure why. The referees called a timeout here at the Blue Cross Arena. The score is 10-4. Lancers up. You just saw a nutmeg earlier from
Perez.
Pupu Perez. We got to come up with a better name. He doesn't like poo-poo.
Poo-poo.
Yeah. And then I don't want to call him the bull because we had the bulldog.
El Toro. How about El Toro?
We had the Irish bull. That's right. I like El Toro. Maybe.
El Toro.
I don't know if that's Cuban, though. We'll find out.
It's Spanish. It's El Toro.
Don Vieira filling in. I tried to explain it earlier. I made some comments in Baltimore about the referee's mom, I think. I don't know. But Kevin Milliken, the commissioner of the league, thought it was Joe Giuliano. Joe got suspended. I sent him blood samples, urine samples. I sent him all kinds of proof that it wasn't Joe, but he suspends Joe Giuliano, that poor guy. So now Joe's stuck in Florida with his family in this snowstorm
it's
here.
It's horrible being down there.
And I mean, he's stuck with his three boys and his wife in beautiful Florida, and we're here doing this broadcast, and it's 0 below 0 here in Rochester, New York. But fans are still here having fun in the Blue Cross Arena. 10-4, Lancers up. John Catalano, our producer. John's been part of this broadcast team in Rochester for the last 20 years. Helped bring sports to TV, radio in this market. There should be, if there is a sports hall of fame in the city, John Catalano should be nominated. Probably will never get in it, but should be at least nominated.
Or a statue. I mean, I think a statue is warranted.
Yes, I will put
like a little statue.
Yeah, real little.
Really little.
We're back here live, Blue Cross Arena. Enrique, trying to feed his friend, childhood friend, Elliot Fauske. And Fauske gives the payback to Enrique. Enrique putting out the Jets there. Here goes Enrique. Step over, looks back for Salas. No, he decides to hang on to him. Goes all the way back to Jake the Snake Schindler. Earthquake Jake. Snake to Ortiz off the bench. Jeremy Ortiz's family was in Baltimore last night to say hello to their son. Made the trip up. I didn't get a chance to say hello to the Ortiz family, but if you're watching or listening, you have a great, great young man in Jeremy Ortiz. Does a lot for this organization on and off the field.
Certainly is. There's a foul there. Don't quite know. Maybe it's the
three line, I think.
No, it's not three line, but I think he fouled Mel. Mauricio, I think, hit Mel.
Yep, hit Mel late. Let's see what they call here.
Just a foul.
Rocky Parada, the voice of the Lancers, our PA announcer doing his magic. And here comes Mel with the ball, almost taken away, given away to Ortiz. But nice defensive play there by Harrisburg. And here come the Heat, but not. Joey steals it and goes to Salas. Mauricio Salas
That's
trying to held
foul.
Up, but he looks. Salas had
a
chance.
Foul there.
No foul, but Salas had a chance to just gently off the boards Ortiz and decides to go for the hard shot. He's got to make a different decision there at times. And here goes Salas, wide open Hoxie, and again goes for the shot instead of the pass to Hoxie. Andrew Hoxie saying, hey, I'm wide open here. Just feed me the ball, nice and gentle. I'll just tap it in.
Feed me.
And here goes our Lancer players here. Joey Campinos all the way over to Gary Bouton looking for Hoxie. Hoxie comes back to get the ball. Hoxie looks for a nice through ball to J.P. Reyes, the Rich Randall lookalike. And Reyes knocked off the ball with a shot, left-footed shot there by Reyes. Just went a little wide. And here come the Lancers again with pressure in the Harrisburg area, Dom.
They seem to be putting a little bit more pressure on the defense, stepping up and putting pressure, trying to cause turnovers. You know, you probably can't play like that all game because you get tired and just can't do it. But they're doing really well as far as turnovers, a little bit more pressure, a couple more goals. And I think that Harrisburg will be disheartened. And this number 22, he's playing very well
Chris,
for Harrisburg.
Yeah, Chris Hall, one of my favorite players. One of my favorite players in the league, Chris Hall.
He's doing very well.
He's going to be a star in this league soon. Chance for Salas, left foot. That might have been a right footed from Hoxie. A little tough on the delivery there. And
it's a tough angle. You know, Mauricio wants on his left, but he's driving the net. You know, the right ball's on his right foot, but you always want to give the ball to Mauricio on his left foot, obviously.
He tried to do the Steve Zungel toe poke. Didn't work out for him. Here comes Salas again. Tries to take on the defender, and here comes Enrique steals it off to
nice
Salas.
Nice play, Enrique.
Nice, unselfish play. Salas had a chance to finish it there. Here comes Enrique again doing his magic. Enrique takes on off the post. Here comes Salas, a chance with a right-footed shot off the post again. Enrique steals it. Look at Joey Tavernese, and the ref says a little tough there. Nice effort there.
Great
by
effort
Enrique.
By Enrique. You can tell he's playing with confidence. It's funny what a turnover and a penalty shot. You know, when you play with confidence, everything seems, you try harder, everything seems going well. It's got to be a three-line pass there. So Enrique, so far, he's playing phenomenal today. Best game I've seen in 3 years.
Val Tessera is probably 6'3", little over 240 maybe. And Enrique is all of maybe 5 foot with his heels on. And
maybe your heels.
No, I don't wear my heels anymore at the game. Nice chat, a goal there by Brad Venino off the boards. Joey Tabernese, the pride and joy. Joey Tabernese was a reject from the Jersey Shores. He could have been on Joey Jersey Shore. Hits it off the boards. It gives it to Brad Venino. Venino with the goal from Tabernese. Lancers up 12-4, Dom.
Yeah, Venino took a shot and hit the boards. It came back to him, and he put it in the corner. You know, the different mindset this quarter. A little bit more pressure on the ball. The ball comes across to Venino. Venino hits, and he has the foresight to go in for the rebound and put it into the net. So, very good so far this quarter. A lot of turnovers. You know, the boys are playing well. Keep it going.
Brad Venino from that area, from the Harrisburg area, from, I think, Reading, PA. I think it's kind of near there. Amish country, I think. We were there last time, Dom. We saw the Amish guys at a gas station. We didn't understand what they were doing there, but they were there filling up their horses. Here we go. Breakaway here by Poo Poo Perez. Sees Foxy White. I'm sorry. Elliot Fowski wide open. The Mohican Warrior mishits it. A little off the key there on the pass there from Poo Poo Perez. Fowski says, hey, man, give me a nice ball, and I'll put it in the net for you and give you the assist. Here comes Poo Poo Perez now. Lancers with all kinds of pressure here for the Harrisburg Heat. And here comes the Heat with a little breakaway. Number 8, Tyler
Whitmer.
Whitmer with the ball, long ball there. Their leading scorer, good player, goes up and over, and it'll be goalkeeper distribution. Lancers up 12-4 here in Rochester, New York. 2 minutes left in the half. Soccer San Fantuzzo are filling in for the vacationing. All right, I'll say it. Johnny Calano, like, you're going to get the guy in trouble. Joe Giuliano is vacationing. Elliot Fowski is on the field playing, and Dom Vieira is substituting for Elliot Fowski, my friend from Dunkin' Donuts. Shot there from the Harrisburg Heat, number 4, Ken Fultz. And a
foul right there in the corner.
Fultz pulls down Salas. Salas is having some issues, man. Players are playing hard. Salas is a forward, but he comes back and plays hard defense. And forwards get in his face and say, hey, guy, we're going to let him put you down. Pulled down. He's got this giant welt on his face getting elbowed last night in Baltimore. And the referee said, play on. I didn't see it. And Sal says, well, but look, you think I was born with this thing on my face? Look, it's like an egg. I wasn't born with this. I didn't have it 10 minutes ago. A minute ago, I didn't have it. The referee said, play on. And here comes Val Tessera from the Harrisburg Heat. Val, a great player. A nice play there by Joey Tabernese, the pride and joy of the Tabernese family, the Garden City Shores. Joey was not a reject from the Jersey Shore TV show. He wanted to be on the show. It didn't work out. He was supposed to be on The Bachelor, and they wouldn't let him on that either. They figured it wouldn't be fair. But he's here on Valentine's Day playing for the fans in Rochester, New York. Joey Tabernese, third leading scorer of the team, and I say the best-looking guy on the team, according to a lot of women in attendance here. One of the best-looking guys down.
And he's got the jersey strut and jersey attitude. So
he does.
I think the women like that.
He's got the double earring.
I wouldn't know anything about that, but, some women like that.
John Catalano, our producer, just got a piercing. He won't tell us where he had it. I think a belly button pierced. They used one of those drywall bits to put his belly button piercing in. But
Big piercing.
Johnny's a hell of a producer, though.
He's a great producer.
Live here, Rochester, New York, 12-4. Lancers up, final minute of play, first half. Great action here. Harrisburg's had a lot of opportunities to stay in this game. Anything could happen in the second half here for the Harrisburg Heat fans. Harrisburg deep into the box right now, and Enrique, my first half player of the game.
Oh, absolutely.
Let's see what happens with the first play action, who they're going to call the Blue Rock player of the game. You and I are calling Enrique our first half player of the game, Blue Rock player of the game.
No doubt. Enrique, Elliott's brought an energy that has been missing at times this year. But so far, I think Enrique, be it through confidence or just getting shifts, he's doing very well. So we just want to get out of this half and kill the half, go in 12-4, regroup, and just keep doing the same things in the second half that we are now, playing very well.
When will that bus trip set in here for the Lancers? Came home early this morning. Let's see what happens in the second half. I hope their legs hold up here in Rochester. Important match. We win this. We're in the playoffs. I love John Wilsbach, the owner of Harrisburg, but John, if we win this, we're in the playoffs. That means an extra home game for our fans here in Rochester, possibly March 5th, Thursday night, two for Thursdays, and we're going to have a lot of fun then that game. First half of action, the Lancers 12-4. Poo-Poo Perez with two goals in the first half of play. Salas with a PK goal, Enrique with a goal and two assists, and
Brad Veneno.
Veneno with a goal, and Andrew Hoxie, the big smooth individual effort, did the juggling thing and got a goal here. Where right now your Lancers are up 12-4 at the Blue Cross Arena in Rochester, New York.
Yeah, the guys are doing great. They understand the importance of the game. They're fighting through. You know they're tired. You know they got in at 7 o'clock in the morning, so they're tired and they're just fighting through and you know their character's coming out. So very good.
Well, I think we're gonna go down to the field soon with. The person that they hired to replace me, the beautiful Brooke, with a Mohican Warrior.
Huge, huge upgrade.
Elliot, awesome first half. How does it feel to finally be back here at the Blue Cross Arena?
Soccer Sammy, it feels amazing to be outside of the Warrior Cave to share the love with everybody on this Valentine's Day. You know it takes a lot for me. The hippies have said make love, not war. I say why not make a lovely war? So on this Valentine's Day, allow me to share with you my favorite love song in celebration. In the 1800s, during the Civil War, the Northern armies picked themselves up like this. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on, ba-dum, ba-da-da-da-dum, ba-da-da-da-dum, glory, glory, hallelujah. You guys are awesome. It's Valentine's, baby. Kiss somebody.
Thank you, Elliot. We're looking for a great next half from the Rochester Lancers. Back to you, Soccer Sam.
Thank you. That is the beautiful Brooke. They hired her to replace me. Did a great job in our first ever interview. Intern from college, intern. Dom, you and I almost went to college. High school got in the way. But
always does, Sammy.
6 years of high school kind of messed me up here. The Lancers are up 12-4 here at the Blue Cross Arena against the Harrisburg Heat. You come back for second half action here. I can't wait. I'm going to hug and kiss someone right now.
Yeah, look for Brooke.
Let's go! Everybody dance now! Rock this party! Dance everybody! Make it hot in this party! Don't stop! Move your body! Rock this party! Dance everybody! Make it hot in this party!
Everybody dance now!
Don't know what's on your mind.
Oh.
We come for you, have a good time. We want you on your waistline. We want you shake your behind. I'm in a dancing mood. Y'all and I'm feeling good. My favorite tune. Put on your dancing tune.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, turn it up the heat on a cold February afternoon. Your Lancer Dancers brought to you by Suntan City World Gym of Rochester and TJT. Photography. And now, ladies and gentlemen, there they are, the Junior Lancer Dancers.
Circus, Afro Circus,
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to. Woman, you're nice, broad face, and you're nice, deep. Woman, you're nice and energetic. Fix your body, you're not to be tight. And woman, you're nice, broad face, and you're nice, deep. Make man flip and bust them lip. Woman, you're nice and energetic. Fix your body, you're not to be tight. And whoa! I like your move and move it. I like your move and move it. I like your move and move it. Yes!
Move it!
And gentlemen, with their friends, the Junior Lancer Dancers.
We are back here, Rochester, New York, the Blue Cross Arena, where the Rochester Lancers are up 12-4 against the Harrisburg Heat. Halftime show was amazing. Elliot Fowski, the Mohican Warrior, joined the Junior Dancers in a routine that he's been practicing for weeks, not knowing that he was going to play tonight. But he did get clearance from our team physicians and our trainer, Travis Johns. And Elliot Fowski is out there playing. Assist. He has an assist tonight on the Enrique goal off the boards. And did a little dance, a little halftime interview, a little tribute to Valentine's Day. And Soccer Sam here filling in for the vacationing Joe Giuliano with Dom Vieira. A shout out there to Ryan Sigich, one of my favorite referees out there. Ryan informed me earlier during the break that one of our referees tonight, Chris Penso, is a FIFA-approved referee who just got back from India doing a game in India, a FIFA referee from India. So Chris right now is doing a great job tonight. When I tease the referees and I make fun of referees and their families and their eyeglasses and all that, it's just when we're losing. I love the referees when we're winning. I got to blame somebody. Right
now? Sure. How did Ryan get the short end of the stick to go to Vegas?
Well, yeah, Ryan got stuck doing the Vegas-San Diego trip, and that's
too
tough.
Bad.
That's
too
tough.
Bad, Ryan. Yeah, Ryan. I feel bad for you.
Yeah.
You know, going to Vegas.
Blistering.
In the middle of a snowstorm. It's horrible.
You know, if you're watching on the television right now, they called for a snowstorm all day. They basically had these snow warnings in effect. Don't leave your house. It's too cold. It's great for business when they do that. I mean, it's just it's a great thing. I love to, like, I love to see one of these weather guys in some type of business say, you know, how about, oh, man. A little dive
got
there.
Got away.
Actually got away with that, maybe.
I think got away with it, but
they thought it was a dive, which was a good call there.
It was a good call, but it would have been a direct PK, right? So, you know, he lunged and, you know, it's over. Move on. Let's get into the game and a little bit more pressure. I love the pressure in the second quarter.
Craig,
down low.
Craig Tyrell took the dive there. The referee didn't buy it, but you got to do that in soccer. Here's Pupu Perez,
good.
One-on-one.
Great play.
Nice, easy goal by Pupu Perez. Third goal of the night.
El Toro.
Pupu Perez from Jake the Snake. Earthquake, Jake Schindler. The Lancers go up 14-0, Dom.
Yeah, great play by Jake. It was all set up by Jake along the boards. He was able to win the ball. Feed El Toro, and he turned around, and he didn't really toe kick a hit with the outside of his left foot into the corner. Great play by Yaquil Perez, El Toro.
14-4, your Lancers are up. Goal by Perez. Assist from...
Back to the hat-trick goal. That was third of the game, right?
Yes.
Hat-trick goal for Perez. As I see a little Cuban flag down there.
Yes.
Make him and Ray proud.
Yes. There's a few Cubans in the Rochester, New York area supporting these guys.
Love Cuban sandwiches.
Yes. Ray Abumu Martinez is excited about things kind of loosening up in Cuba and the United States, hoping to someday see his mom, who he hasn't seen in 17 years. And Ray's a great, great man. And
yes,
gets absolutely very emotional when he talks about not being able to see his mom. But he defected. He was with the Cuban national team. They were playing in the United States here many years ago and decided to take a run for it in L.A. and just never went back.
So, absolutely. So that would be great to facilitate Ray going back, or his mom being able to come here. It would make Ray hard. Imagine not being able to see your mom, or your family for that matter, you know, for 17 years.
you know, through being a young man. And, you know, it's been tough on Ray. Good man.
Yes,
great heart.
Right here at Blue Cross Arena, Lancers up 14-4. Soccer Sam filling in for Joe Giuliano. Dom Vieira, Duncan Dom Vieira filling in for Elliot Fowski. And John Catalano, our producer extraordinaire. We talked about John. He wanted to give a shout-out to the four beautiful women in his life, his beautiful wife and three daughters. Happy Valentine's Day from your dad, John. I paused on that one.
Are you sure about that?
I was going to say something else, but better not. Yeah. If you're listening, watching on the MASL Network, some great games today. Milwaukee and Syracuse just got underway. Tulsa is at Missouri. Chicago at Detroit later on tonight. And Turlock at Sacramento. And Sunday, tomorrow, relax and enjoy all the games. Brownsville is at Dallas. Syracuse at Chicago. And Texas at Monterrey, Mexico. Get to watch all the games on Go Live Sportscast and MASLsoccer.com.
Yeah, tough weekend for Syracuse. You know, they have, you know, back-to-back travel from Milwaukee to Chicago tomorrow. I believe it's in the afternoon also. Somewhat what we did, you know, a few weeks ago, very hard on you physically. Chicago's going to be there waiting, and we're going to see what happens. If they lose and we win today, we have the exact same record. You know, as far as that goes.
Armando Gamboa, the owner, coach of the current reigning PASL champions, the Mustangs from Chicago. Great man, Armando. I talked to him earlier today.
Yes, I heard you, yes.
Great
good man.
Great for this sport and the city of Chicago. It's tough when you're in a big city like that. There's so much going on. I think a lot of us are spoiled here in Rochester. We don't have a lot of big sports going on here and a lot of big events. So, you know, it's just, you know, the focus for the media and the attention we get is a little different than some of the bigger cities get. But he's getting attention by winning a great team, great players.
Great
and
product.
A lot of big cities, that's how they do it. San Diego's done it for years and years with their product. And now you see in Vegas, a big city like Vegas, and what they're the coverage they're getting now because they're winning and how great they're playing. So a lot of great teams out there, Dallas Sidekicks. Ronnie Davis and his team over there are doing a great job, the game of soccer, and of course the Missouri Comets, Brian Bud Budinski. Brian and I are personally responsible for saving a lot of restaurants and bars in Missouri that were failing.
Very good.
We went in for a night, and all of a sudden they made a lot of profits.
That's good. But you and Brian did a good job.
Yeah, missed that guy, man. Missed playing against Missouri. And
great organization.
Yeah.
Great organization. Having a great year.
Tanner's playing Milwaukee. Giuliano Oliveira tonight, the coach of Milwaukee this afternoon. A good friend of this show. And Tommy Tanner, obviously one of my best friends. Wish him luck with the Syracuse Silver Knights tonight in Milwaukee.
Yep.
And then tomorrow, Tommy drives up to Chicago. So we'll see what happens. A lot of great games. I can't wait to watch them all. I love just relaxing and watching these MASL games, the greatest soccer league in the world right now, the MASL Major Arena Soccer League. And right now, my favorite team, the Rochester Lancers, with Joey Tavernese off the post there, just wide and then taken down. Looks like Jeremy Ortiz was taken down.
Correct, yes.
By Bradley Kerstetter.
No, great play, great hustle. Mauricio just shot it would have been a three-pointer. Good save by the goalie.
Yeah.
But you see how effectively it is when you start using the boards. I think half of the Baltimore goals yesterday was just a simple play off the board. You know, I think we scored one or two goals today. And it's just a matter of getting that ball off the boards, making runs into the box and getting a shot on net. So
Tim Melder,
very good.
Tim Melder with a nice save. Goalkeeper extraordinaire for the Harrisburg Geek. Nice save on Mauricio Salas from Brazil. Mauricio Salas. He's going to wind up here. Nice hard on Hoxie off the boards.
You know, Mauricio just wants a three-pointer. He's just winding up, and he wants a goal. He wants a goal.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes, you know, Kevin Wolf, they're playing up and down there for Harrisburg, playing good, but now a breakaway for Andrew Hoxie off the pipes. And, oh! Elliot Fowski off the pipes again, and Elliot was ready to celebrate. He was ready to do his dance and whatever.
The Mohican dance. He's ready to do the Mohican dance. Val to share a foul. Andrew Hoxie.
I don't know if Johnny can show this, but he tickled him. I swear, Val to share tickled Andrew Hoxie. Hoxie hit his hands against the board, and Val just gave him the little tickle. And here we go. Here it goes. Look now, Hoxie's guarding his body. He looks behind him. It's like, here you go, little let me little tickle. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Did you see that?
What's the noise? What's the noise that Pillsbury Doughboy used to make? Almost.
Woo-hoo. Wow. Woo, that felt good. Nice shot there by the Mohegan Warrior.
Elliot's coming so close.
If
so
Elliot
close.
Scores here, this crowd with the RIT marching band in the crowd tonight, this crowd is going to erupt. There's probably over 5,000 fans here tonight despite the weather. Thank you all for coming to Rochester in these weather conditions, snow warning in effect. But they're here to support the team. We appreciate it.
No, to everybody's credit, you know, everybody's here. You know, a lot of people came. It affected the attendance somewhat. But to have this many people and, you know, people are just tired of snow and it started raining, or snowing rather, I wish it was raining, you know, an hour before the kickoff, and that affects everything. So kudos to everybody for coming, and thank you.
We are going to go to break here on the Lancers Broadcast Network. The Lancers up 14-4.
Kick or visit ourlancers.com.
3, 2, 1, go!
Dom, happy Valentine's Day.
Wow.
Oh, there he is. Dom Vieira, there he is.
With a grin.
This is my buddy, man.
I was a little scared, you know, in the middle of that transaction.
I put the lip gloss on, and I was going to give you a nice one, but I decided not to. Here we go. The Lancers up 14-4. Harrisburg Heat in town. This is a must-win game for the Lancers to make the playoffs. Mauricio Salas, left foot, had Perez right next to him. Perez with the first hat trick of the year, his first hat trick of the year, thanks to Eric Trendle. With the report, Eric Trendle in the house. Catalano and I and Trendle have been together for many years in this business of soccer in this community, this great community, Rochester, New York. Home of three professional teams, the Rhinos, the Western New York Flash, and the winner, Rochester Lancers, my favorite indoor team. When I'm here, unless I get fired again. I hate when I get fired. Here it is, Gary Bouton, a breakaway. The pride and joy of Buffalo, New York. Looks for Pupu Perez off the boards. Little hits it a little wrong off the boards. You know, it's an art, but a lot of people think I make excuses, but the Lancers never get to practice here. And where they do practice, it's a whole different boarding system. So, you know, it's like it's no different. You have no home field advantage. That's the problem. There's absolutely no home field advantage. Perez was a little upset there and kicked it out.
He was, yes. You know, a little frustrated. A little frustrated. You're right. You know, you do have to get used to the surroundings. But, you know, it is what it is. That's the cards we're dealt, and we just have to play.
And I think the Blue Cross Arena staff did a great job putting out the turf. It's very, very smooth. And the lines you see, the bumps you see, it's just the camera angles and the type of cameras that Catalano and his crew are using. But this field is as smooth as could be right now.
Yes. Sort of like your lips when you gave me a kiss on the kiss
yes.
cam.
Was that good?
That was great.
Thank you. I want a little shout out to my wife, Linda. Happy Valentine's Day, honey. I got you a nice pink shovel, and we're going to do some
Absolutely.
Bonding later on. We're going to be shoveling the sidewalks together. Can't wait. Well,
she'll be shoveling the sidewalks.
I love her. Joey Campinos with the ball right now. Speaking of love, I got my grandson Santino here hugging me throughout the broadcast. He's my bodyguard on the away trips, but him and my grandson Salvatore are here showing support. I know this doesn't sound professional to those of you that want an ESPN-type broadcast, but there it is right there. It is a Lancers goal. Jeremy Ortiz off of goalkeeper Tim Mel. Mauricio Salas will get the assist. Salas to Ortiz. The Lancers go up 16-14, Dom.
A lot of great things happened there. Mauricio gave the pass into Tavernese. Joey held it. He then saw Mauricio coming in trailing. Mauricio unleashes his shot, and then Jeremy just goes to the net. And the rebound comes to him, and he has an open net. Just very simple, but very productive.
Jeremy Ortiz with the goal. Lancers go up 16-4. In the end of the first quarter in Milwaukee, the Syracuse Silver Knights, my good friend Tommy Tanner, they're up 3-2, single point scoring there.
3-2.
3-2 in Milwaukee. Best of luck to Tommy Tanner and the Syracuse Silver Knights, my good friend there and my partner, really. We all came into this together. Tommy Tanner, Ed Hale, and I, we decided to to keep this Eastern Division together as a group and great partners in this game. And it's tough when we play against each other. Like last night, we're coming home from Baltimore, and Ed Hale texts me, and he says, I feel bad, you know, winning against you. I mean, I want to win for my team. I feel, and I tell, that's exactly how I feel when we play Syracuse.
Absolutely.
I mean, I hate, I don't want to lose, but when we beat them, I feel bad for Tommy and his family, especially if we're in Syracuse. So we'll see what happens, though. This playoff game against Syracuse, obviously, the Lancers are officially, I'll call it official right now, 16-4 up against the Heat. We are in the playoffs, and we'll be playing Syracuse. Elliot Fowski tried to feed Enrique, with a ball, and Enrique steals the ball and goes back to Jake the Snake, the Earthquake, Jake Schindler. Jake's a great player, great person. These guys all do so much off the field in our great community.
What a lot of people don't know is that Jake broke his leg in the summertime, and he started the year. Maybe he came back a little too early, but to his credit, he fouled Aaron Teixeira. You know, so, you know, great by Jake. It shows us his character to come back, and maybe a little early.
Teixeira
better.
Teixeira just, he kind of rode on Hoxie's mustache. You see that, Dom?
He did. He's a big, big guy.
He is.
Strong.
He's a great player, too. I mean.
Yes, you can tell. He's a little heavier now, a little older. But
I think he's fit as could be. I just think that's, he's
like
solid.
He's like eating Portuguese chorizo, I think.
Yeah, but he's a great player. Harrisburg right now, two goals. It's 16-4, two-point goals, multi-point scoring here in Rochester, New York. Harrisburg, Rochester, Baltimore, and Syracuse are testing this. Jamie Capinos.
There you go.
Jamie Capinos with an assist to Mauricio Salas. Maybe a little too easy for Salas. Salas scores that one. And the Lancers are up 18-4. The fans here are having a good time in Rochester, New York.
Great ball by Jamie. You know, Mauricio was left alone. The goalie made it hard for him by coming out and charging him. But the Mauricio had the presence of mind to stick it by the goalie. So, you know, what is it, 18-4? I think we can start celebrating. Chupa!
You know, it's a situation like that, you kind of feel bad for Harrisburg. We were there year one of the Lancers in the new MISL, and we joined the MISL. We were getting beat, you know, in the 20s against some teams. The teams have been around for a while. And, you know, we looked forward to playing the newer teams in the league at the time, Norfolk and Syracuse, and we were competitive. But we played teams that had been around for a while. It was a challenge. And right now, Harrisburg is feeling that challenge. And it's like you said, Dom, just a few years, a couple key players, and things change.
Oh, absolutely.
We still can't beat Baltimore, though. We beat Missouri in the past. We beat Milwaukee in the past. We've never beaten Baltimore. And hopefully we get to beat them in the playoffs. And there, Elliot Fowski with a chance here, the Warrior, off of the pass off the boards from Poo-Poo. What'd you call him?
El Toro.
El Toro Perez from Cuba.
You got to roll your R's, Sammy. Toro.
Toro. Here comes Harrisburg with the ball. Cash with the ball, doing his magic right now. Dave Cash, good player for Harrisburg, goes back to goalkeeper, Mr. Tim Mel. Mel looking down deep. Doesn't happen the way he wants it. And unbelievable. It's the turf. This
second
happened
time
before.
This year. Second time this year it's happened.
Second time this year and the same goal.
Yeah.
Joey Capinos gave up a bad one. A bad back pass to Veneno. And I know Doug Miller's upset right now because he talked about this in pregame. Like, guys, no back pass to the goalie. The turf is rough in front of the net. Don't do it. Yeah. They did it. Yeah. And Capinos didn't expect it. Oh. And unfortunately, here it goes here. Well, here's the ball from Mel. Mel almost gets an assist here. Long ball to Mel, all the way down. And then Veneno just turns around, gives Joey a nice easy one. And Joey just bounces and goes in. And it is.
It's unfortunate.
18-6. We'll give that. I don't know who they give the goal. I guess you give the goal
to the goalie.
The goalie. Mel with the goal here.
Or maybe an own goal, but.
I think it's Tim Mel with the goal. Tim Mel with the goal.
We'll give it to Tim Mel. We'll give it to Tim Mel.
Tim Mel with the goal.
You know,
if you're with the league, if Sydney from the league, you're doing stats for the league, we're giving it to Tim Mel. And I don't care. Suspend me again if you want. I don't care. I've gotten so many suspensions from Kevin Milken in the past. One more is not going to hurt me.
Yeah. You know, I'm sure Doug is upset. Doug Miller is upset right now.
Are you kidding me?
You know,
he took off his Valentine's Day tie.
Yeah, I mean, you tell kids when you pass it back to the goalie, never on the goal, off to the side. You know,
Here we go. Here we go. Tim Mel with the ball right now. Tim Mel all the way down.
All the way down.
And now, it doesn't touch anyone but our player. And if it touches off your own player, it's the last player to touch it. It gets the goal. So it bounced off of Veneno's foot into the goal.
Yes,
Tim
exactly.
Mel, goalkeeper, gets a goal. Congratulations, yeah. Tim Mel and the Mel family.
There you go.
Timmy first with a goal. Probably his first goal as a goalkeeper.
Yeah. So if anything, Brad made the correct play, but put more of an angle on it away from the goal, more into the corner, and then just even if it goes underneath his foot. But that's okay. You know, you live and learn, and a young player.
Yeah.
And it's all about growth. Right now it's a free kick.
That's what my wife
inside,
tells me. Yeah.
Inside the three-point line, it's a free kick for Teixeira. He's dangerous with his left foot.
I tell you, someday I will grow up. Here comes Val Teixeira with the shot here. J.P. Reyes was called with the foul. Back to Teixeira. Nice defense here on the Lancers. They're putting a lot of pressure on these guys. And here's Lito Enrique. Enrique was a handball at Harrisburg. They didn't call it. And wait a minute. Yes, they did call it.
They called the handball against Harrisburg?
Wow, they called
the
handball.
They didn't play
advantage.
No.
What are you going to do? It happens. Again, when you're winning, you don't blame the referees. But referees, it's tough. It's such a fast game. This is not like any other sport in America. It's so, so fast. Nobody's walking here. It's just high speed, high action. Nice pass there from Hoxie to Elliot Fowski. Fowski looking for a tease. Goes over all the way back to Jamie Capinos. Capinos tries to steal the ball. It doesn't happen. Jamie Capino wants to get a goal for the bad goal that his brother Joey gave up. The Wonder Twins, the first pair of twins in the history of the Rochester Lancers organization. Back from the 1970s pro team, there's never been a pair of twins on the same team. According to Andrew Battisti, there has been twins that have played professional soccer on the same team, but never for the Lancers organization. Here goes Jeremy Ortiz feeding Hoxie in the corner. Hoxie using his body well, comes around, does the smooth move, dances, looks for Salas, couldn't get back to him, wanted to give it back to Salas, and he couldn't. Salas goes back to Basso, Stephen Basso. Stephen Basso's dad is back in the country and showed up in Baltimore to support his son. Great family, the Basso family from Maryland. Not really from Italy, like we say in the announcements. We say that he's from Campo Basso, Italy, Stephen Basso, but he is from Maryland. Stevie's a great kid. Glad he came back. Him and Ortiz joined us after different teams in the offseason. Ortiz played in Australia. Basso played for Ontario with Bernie Lillebois, who's in the playoffs and doing a great job. But Stephen wanted to be closer to home, closer to his family, and he's here with the Lancers, Dom.
He did, and to his credit, he left California, and, you know, family's important to Steve. So he wanted to be closer to Baltimore, and, you know, he's familiar with Rochester. He knew Rochester. He's familiar with the area. So more than glad to have him back. You know, we have core players, and Gary Bouton's a core player, you know, and... You know, Mauricio Salas, obviously a core player. That's a foul on off of Gary. Mauricio's going to try to shoot. I thought he's going to try to shoot the three-pointer there. You know, so right there. A game to him.
That was
give and go. That was Mauricio Salas from Gary Bouton.
Gary Bouton, what a play. It was all Gary Bouton going to Mauricio Salas, the Brazilian, our leading scorer now with, I believe, 33 goals. The Lancers go up 20-6 now against the Harrisburg Heat.
Exactly. It was a nice give and go. I thought he was going to take the three-pointer right here. But, you know, he looked for Gary, and then he checked to him, and he was able to get the shot off. Nice little set piece between Gary and Maurizio with 1.3 seconds left to go in the third quarter. So, very good. You know, they just regrouped from that own goal, and now just keep pushing forward.
Doing a great job.
Finish off the game the right way.
Yes, look at, wow, I can't, they're going to show him or her, or I can't see who that is.
Oh, yeah, she's at the TSC.
Oh, yes.
That's Pedro.
They were showing Pedro, that's
Pedro.
Right.
Pedro.
Pedro came back yesterday, Pedro Franco, called Pedrinho Franco, knee injury. And
that's Roberto Costa sitting next to him.
Yes, Roberto Costa and Pedro doing a thing. A little shout out before we go to break to Josh Kippenberger, Craig Elston, and my friend Don Vieira. We'll be back.
Yeah. Thank you.
Congratulations to our lucky season ticket holder, Mindy. You've received a gift card courtesy of Price Rise.
final 15 minutes of action starts right now.
We are back here live in Rochester, New York, the Blue Cross Arena. The Lancers lead the Harrisburg Heat 20-6. We are in the Ide Family of Dealerships Broadcast Center, brought to you by Blue Rock Energy, Salvatore's Pizza, Palmer's Direct Heat Market, Salino and Barnes, Dunkin' Donuts, Holiday Inn Airport, TSC Sports Clips, Distillery, Stokes & Vicka CPAs, and the Ide Family of Dealerships. A shout out to all you guys that make this broadcast possible. We really appreciate all your support. And another shout out to my man Alan Balthrop from the Dallas Sidekicks. Alan and Craig and Josh help out, help us with a national show on the iHeartRadio on Kick This Worldwide every week. So thank you guys for what you do for the MASL, the Major Arena Soccer League. And Joey Capino's got a little nervous there. The ball went back to him. He's like, hey, I'm not letting another one in.
You think he was a little nervous when he got that ball?
Yeah, he's like, oh, no, I can't. How embarrassing was that? But here comes the Harrisburg Heat. They want it. Wolf with the ball right now, looking back to the captain, Val Teixeira. He's got the armband with the nice C on it for captain. When I played, I used to wear an armband, and it had a C on it, but it was for cooler. I was in charge of the cooler.
Cooler. Now. Is that what it was? Cooler.
Yeah. Whoa, high shot there from number, wow, I can't see who that is. That's Patrick Thompson, I believe.
Yes, it was.
For the Harrisburg Heat.
Yes, it was. Patrick
we Thompson. Are in a room right now, and I'm not sure how Joe Giuliano does this. There's no lighting up here, so we, you know, you got all these notes, all this preparation, but you can't see anything. And my phone died. I was using my phone as a light, and I can't see anything, so I can't read my own notes here. Yes, John Catalano, producer, says that he cannot put us on the air. He can't have any light in here because of the way we look. Don, I think he's referring to me, though. You are one good-looking man, Don.
Well, thank you, Sammy.
Yes. And here comes the Lancers with the ball right now. J.P. Reyes, bad pass, got knocked off the ball. And here comes the Harrisburg Heat. Harrisburg, open shot. What a save. Amazing save by Joey Capinos. Hoxie, a little too confident there. Teixeira's all over Hoxie. Andrew Hoxie had a one-on-one break with the goalkeeper and kind of like was playing around a little bit. And here comes Mauricio Salas from Brazil. Misreads Hoxie. Hoxie was supposed to go to the corner, and Salas put the ball where it was supposed to be, but Hoxie didn't read it. They practiced that and practiced a lot. Salas steals the ball to Hoxie. Hoxie one-on-one, and goalkeeper Timothy Mal with a nice save and release. And here comes the Harrisburg Heat. Lancers up 20-6, fourth quarter action. The Rochester Lancers are officially in the playoffs, and Jamie Capinos put a header off the scoreboard and kind of getting yelled at by his brother Joey. He's like, hey, easy, I didn't do it on purpose. You just gave up a goal, went under your foot, and you're worried about me heading it off the boards? Calm down.
It's going to be a long dinner tonight.
Yeah. These guys are not going to be talking later.
You make the food. No,
you make the food. Here comes Val Teixeira.
Timeout.
That rule has to change, honestly. Yeah. Kevin Milliken, if you're listening right now, whenever a team has a direct kick and they line up, pretend they're going to kick and call timeout, that just slows down the game. That can't happen. That rule has to be eliminated. It's ridiculous. If you don't know what to do at this level, and you can't read what the defense is doing, and you can't read what the goalkeeper's doing, then you shouldn't be playing at this level. And our team is accused of doing that, too. I hate when that happens. You get all excited. It's a direct kick. Slows everything down. Here it goes. What a save by Capinos. Look at this. Here's a great shot here. It was going to be a three. No, look, point blank, right off his face, his chin. He's got the little beard working.
And again, that comes off a turnover.
Yes.
And that's what we, against Harrisburg, no offense to Harrisburg, we get away with it. We do it against Baltimore.
Or Missouri in the playoffs.
Missouri.
Or San Diego. You know,
it's a goal. Yeah. So that's what we cannot do. Kick it into the corner. We cannot give a wall away.
Oh, believe me, Doug Miller went nuts on J.P. Rass for giving up that ball there. J.P. got knocked off the ball. I mean, it's not, sometimes when you see something like that, it's because players get knocked off.
Exactly, yeah. And as far as this, the timeouts, I agree with you totally, Sam.
Look, there's one of the referees, Jimmy Papalitis.
Oh,
he's in
there
the crowd
he is. There.
There
he is.
Look at he's got his dog with him. No, he doesn't. No.
Easy.
Yeah, easy.
You know, again, they call the timeout, and did they need to call a timeout to do what they did?
No, I mean, you call a timeout for what? I mean, come on.
And it was a disaster, the play. Yeah. And I've seen it even on our part.
I've seen it at a lot of levels, a lot of teams. That rule needs to go away. The reason people love this sport is because it's unlike any other sport. It's nonstop action, up and down, no walk in here. You can't stop the play in any way. You got to keep it moving. Lancers up 20-6 against the Heat, the Harrisburg Heat.
You know, you practice for a reason. That's why you practice those.
Right.
No matter who you have on, be it the second forward, third forward, if you go in twos or threes, they need to know.
Look at,
you know.
Look at Mel there.
Great footwork.
Tim Mel wants another goal. He's got one goal. He's like, I want one more goal. The fans are up right now trying to win a soccer ball. And here's Harrisburg with a shot, a goal.
Another goal, yes.
Wow, you can't give up goals like that against any team. Like you said, the mistakes that happen. Number four for Harrisburg, Ken Fultz with the goal. Nice goal from Ken Fultz. I didn't see who assisted it, Dom. I'm not sure you caught it. We'll see the replay here and find out who assisted it here.
You know, but I think it was Thompson who worked it down the wing. I mean, a big, strong man.
Thompson, just nice
but
little
right
ball.
Now, you know, Jamie can't be near his brother. He's not playing goal. His brother is. So he's got to have his head on a swivel and see who's out there. You know, he was in way too deep.
Doug's not going to be happy about that, Doug Miller. 20-8, Harrisburg goes up. Goal by Ken Fultz. Ken Fultz with a goal.
I believe so, yes. Ken Fultz did.
Nice job.
Let's get back in the game. Again, you take the foot off the gas pedal. And that's natural, you know, but you're still going to do well defensively.
And here comes the Harrisburg. He put some pressure on. Thompson's a pretty good player. Does the moves, a lot of dancing there. Took on two players, just moved around him. Shot, and
Great save.
I was going to say goal by number 22, Chris Hall. But yes. No, just hit it again. Like you said, some teams that goes in. I mean, that we had the same problem. We missed the easy chances. That was an easy chance. You can't miss that, Chris. Other players, the Lancers are guilty of that too. Teams like Baltimore don't miss the easy chances. They make it happen. They make you pay. And here comes Gary Bouton, the pride and joy of Buffalo, New York. It used to be the Buffalo Bills. I'm not sure if they're still around, but here comes Gary Bouton. Great ball to Veneno, who should have buried that, rushed it. What a ball by the pride and joy, Gary Bouton to Veneno. Benino's still on the ball, looking back from Mauricio Salas. Goes all the way back to Salas. Bad ball. Mauricio's like, I'm right here. You don't have to kill it to me. And he does. And now a breakaway for Harrisburg. Chance here for the Heat. Off the boards. Nobody there. Poor distribution.
You know,
and here comes Salas looking for Hoxie. Salas is looking for someone to kind of overlap, and he kind of slows it down, saying, hey, we're up 20-8. No need to keep on pressing here, guys. We've been victims of this kind of stuff in the past. We don't want to be doing this to other teams. If we don't, we could avoid it. Let's just not let them score any more goals. Let's be sportsmanlike about it and just play some soccer and have some fun and entertain the fans without embarrassing anybody. Harrisburg came, have a long bus ride, bad weather. Salas.
Great shot by Mauricio.
Mauricio Salas, unbelievable angle. I don't even know how that went in. I don't know, but I think Jamie Capinos.
Well, that's Ortiz, Sammy. Ortiz gains the zone, and Mauricio makes the overlap, and he just puts it to the corner, and he just blasts it on the net.
I get it. All right, Mauricio Salas with a goal. Our producer's telling me it's a twin brother, so I'm thinking Jamie assisted it, but he was talking about my twin brother in the crowd.
On the screen, oh, gotcha.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he just blows that right by him.
What a shot by Mauricio Salas. Mel's like, what am I doing?
Yeah. You know what Mel means in Portuguese?
No.
Honey.
What does it mean?
Honey.
Honey?
Sweetness. Mel means honey in Portuguese.
Mel's like, man, this is a little different than outdoor soccer.
Let me get out of here.
Mel doesn't realize that Mauricio Salas has the hardest shot in all of soccer in America and just put one effortlessly. That's what he does. And, you know, like any good really goal scorer, I mean, you want them to shoot from anywhere.
Absolutely.
Sometimes Mauricio gets accused of being selfish, but you want that. That's what you're designed to do. That's what your makeup is. That's what got you here. That's what made you the highest paid player in the MASL, one of the leading scorers in the MASL, is that you want to score goals. That's why fans come and see you.
Absolutely. At times we get mad at the players. Why don't you shoot? Why don't you shoot? So it takes a certain confidence level. See the work right there by Elliot? Doesn't stop. Doesn't stop.
He's like the energy. What is it, Energizer? Yep.
You know, so got to be a foul on Teixeira there. Got to be a what's the foul on? No, he called it. He called on Hoxie or Foxy.
Man, good thing Elliot didn't get hit in the head there. Elliot's been suffering.
Yeah,
I meant to tell you earlier. Was in a construction accident many years ago and had some brain issues with concussion syndrome. Was fine for a few years. Played some outdoor soccer this past summer and.
got an elbow to the head and kind of re-aggravated his concussion syndromes. And unfortunately, wasn't able to play all year. And
top of the arc now.
Bad clearance by Mel, top of the arc.
How could he not call that top of the arc? Wow.
Well, it happens.
It's 22-8. I understand. Yeah. I understand. You know, so
Lancer's ball, bad clearance there by Tim Mel, goalkeeper for the Harrisburg Heat. You know, you get rattled when you're down 22-8. You get a little rattled, and the Lancers just called a timeout.
I swear
we should find someone for that. Absolutely no reason to take a timeout at this point in the game, at this event. That needs a change.
Yes.
Kevin Milken, you know I love you. Please change this rule. Get your rules committee. No timeouts on kicks. Keep the game moving. No need for that. But Don Vieira, you are filling in right now for Joe. You're filling in for Elliot Fowski. I'm filling in for Joe Giuliano. Yeah. Joey's watching and listening. I'm Sam Fantuzzo, Soccer Sam. That's what the producer tells me. I did the Baltimore game last night by myself. It was difficult. I learned a lot. I did the best I could. And tonight, you know, this is a challenge. It is. We're in a dark room here. We can't read our notes or see our notes. Our producer says I can't read anyway, but he says he did it on purpose because he doesn't want anyone to see us on camera because of
our looks.
This thing. What is the thing?
It's called a nose.
Yeah. Dude, this nose, man. I got to pay sales tax on this baby. It's so big. But
you got to pay property tax.
Property tax, yeah.
Occupies a lot of land.
Well, shout out there to all the owners of the MASL, all the people that work for all the different teams. Thank you so much for how hard you work to keep this great league around. First year in existence, we are so far advanced. I can tell you, being involved for many, many years in soccer and the stories I've heard, we are so far above other leagues that took them 20 years to get where we're at as an organization. So thank you to the A-share owners, the B-share owners, and everyone involved to get this league off the ground and get things rocking and rolling. And I'm sure next year there'll be one scoring system. We wanted to test it this year. 1 point, multi-point. It's probably going to go to 1 point, I would imagine. And that's what the majority want. That's what it'll be. But it was a great test for this year. And like any new leagues, you have to test things. Here comes the Lancers with a shot, Salas, trying for another three-pointer.
You know,
off the kick here.
Exactly, Sammy. As Mr. Hale said today, you know, we have 20-something teams in the league. When we started off year one, I think it was seven teams. Year two, six teams. So, you know, it should be another goal. Yes, great play. Again, using the boards. You know, Joey Tavernese to Jeremy Ortiz. Jerry makes the run, and he puts it into the corner. But getting back to what I was saying, you know, the first year was six teams. Seven teams the second year. It made it tough for travel. And, you know, if we can get some more teams in the Northeast, you know, make it a little bit more games, you know, so we're not seeing, you know, so many times Syracuse, so many times Baltimore and what have you. It would be great.
What a goal here. Tavernese, unselfish, little soft pass to Ortiz. They read it. They would have practice every day. The Lancers up 24-8. And, Dom, I'm going to tell all you fans out there, we're hoping that we go to Baltimore, that we beat Syracuse and we go to Baltimore. But whatever happens, Don Bier and I will be at every city during the playoffs as long as the Lancers aren't playing, and we're going to support this league. And we hope that everyone involved in the league and all you fans go to different cities. A lot of inexpensive airfares out there. Drive, gas is cheap right now. Let's go and support every city in this great league throughout the playoffs, and let's see what happens in this playoff race. I can't wait to kind of visit Missouri, our old friends in Missouri, and maybe get
Dallas would be great.
In San Diego, and like a one-on-one here again for Harrisburg. And
now a little pushing and shoving there. You know, a lot of frustration when you're losing 24-8.
Yeah, Jake did the right thing. Jake said, hey,
just walk away.
I understand you're frustrated.
Walk
I'm
away.
Sorry. I'm sorry I hit you a little late there. Yeah. And Jake did the right thing by pulling back, saying, hey, it shouldn't have happened. Yeah. And
like you said, Sammy, we've been there.
Yes.
Where teams are pounding the heck out of us. And as owners, we're saying, really, guys? You guys really have to keep pushing? You know, we've been there against Baltimore when they're thrashing us, and Syracuse when they were thrashing us a few times.
Yeah.
And that's not fun.
Yeah,
it's frustrating.
Not fun. I stopped talking to Tommy Tanner for like 24 hours because of that.
Yeah. You know, you're up. I think one game they're up like 14 points. They're still attacking pressing. So
Eric Trendle keeps
you know,
on giving
fun.
Me. Speaking of Syracuse, Eric Trendle, PR director extraordinaire, Syracuse and Milwaukee at the half, 4-4, single point scoring.
Great game.
Great game for Tanner. Tanner wants to win this. Tanner wins this game. He's in the playoffs officially. If not, Detroit still has a chance. Detroit hosts Chicago tonight in Detroit. Great place to play. Love that small arena. Fans really into it there. Great city, Detroit. The Cicluna family, now without Dominic, do a great job for the sport of soccer in that area. Here comes J.P. Reyes from Tabernese. Tabernese gives it to Reyes, and Reyes looks, doesn't see Tabernese. Joey looks at him like, man, I gave you the ball. You got to pass it back.
Well, he made the right play by cutting in. He he's a left footer.
All right, we'll be back here on the Lancers Broadcast Network. The Lancers up 24-8 here live in Rochester, New York.
Congratulations to Theo. You have received a free haircut courtesy of Sport Clips.
We are back live here in Rochester, New York on the Lancers Broadcast Network. The Lancers up 24-8 against the Harrisburg Heat. Soccer Sam Fantuzzo here filling in for Joe Giuliano with Dom Vieira filling in for Elliot Fowski. Good morning, Dom, or good afternoon, Dom.
I think it's good afternoon right now. But so 6 more minutes left to go. Let's finish it out. You know, gain a playoff berth. That's what we set out to do, one step at a time. You know, so just let's kill. So you don't need to score a bunch of goals. Just play good defensively and just kill the game.
Knock it around a little bit. I know you don't. They probably want to entertain the fans, but there's no need to overdo it here. And you know, we, like you said, Don, we had been there as an organization for many years when teams went up by 20 goals or 20 points, and it's not fun for anybody. This Harrisburg team is a good team, though. They had a lot of chances, and like us, against some of the more powerful teams in the league, we missed the easy chances. They missed a lot of easy chances that could have kept them in the game, and that happens.
Absolutely. They get some players to build on, you know, and I guarantee you that next year, even if they were to keep the same core, they would do much better.
Right. Guys, you know, get more confident. They learn the game, learn how to use the boards, and they learn how to defend off the boards.
Yeah.
That's what we struggle to do at times, and tonight Harrisburg has struggled to defend off the boards. Joey Tavernese right there tried to steal the ball from Kevin Wolf, the Wolf man. Kevin Wolf playing hard. Probably my player of the game for Harrisburg. Kevin Wolf up and down, working hard for this team.
Yeah, I like Wolf. I like Cash. You know, number 22.
Chris Hall, number
Chris
22.
Hall.
Great player.
He, you know, those guys have played well.
Tim
number
Mel.
88.
Yeah. Tim Hell.
Thompson.
Yeah, Tim Mel, the goalkeeper, kept him in the game. Hoxie with the ball right now, looking for off the boards to Gary Boughton, the pride and joy of Buffalo, New York. Gary hits it wide. And Sal's taking his time there, and here comes Harrisburg. No pressure. Here comes Steven Stefano Basso from Maryland. A little shout-out to the Basso family, great people. And Papa Basso back from his tour, supporting our country. Enrique with a chance for his second goal of the night. A little slow off there. And a nice sliding save there by Bradley Kerstetter.
Exactly. That, again, one more example of what we're talking about. He had plenty of time. That was a great pass by Hoxie. So it was a restart right now in the corner. Hit the post. You know, Enrique got to finish that.
Yeah, it's about speed. Like I said to you, it's about how the brain goes to the feet. It all has to happen faster in indoor soccer. It all has to happen faster. That's why I don't play, obviously. We are live here in Rochester, New York. The Lancers are home Thursday night here, 7 p.m. Kids are home from school. The kids are driving you crazy. Take them to the Lancer game. $10 tickets available. And bring your group. If you're a soccer coach, you want to sit there and play around with cones and do all that stuff. That's great. But kids, you want to really teach the kids. You teach them right here at a Lancers game.
Too many men right now. I think Perez jumped on. And I think we got too many men on the field. So
silly foul here from the Lancers. Doug Miller's pointing to Joey Tavernese.
Can't do that.
And Perez, Doug's upset right now. He doesn't like silly. Doug is all business. He doesn't care right now if they're up 24-8. There's Rich Randall's parents on the scoreboard right there. Rich Randall, the president of the Lancers, Doug Miller, Kayla Clark, Donna Wasdorp at the time sat me down and said, Sam, forget about we can't get dates at the Blue Cross Arena. We have to continue this team. The city loves this team. We'll play whatever dates they give us. Yeah, we have to play on Valentine's Day at 1 o'clock. Yeah, we have to play 1 o'clock games in the middle of winter around the holidays, but we have to do this for our fans, and I'll tell you, Dom, I am so happy we did this, and we're not going anywhere. I don't care. These fans in Rochester proved that no matter how bad the dates are, they're going to show up to support us. So we're here. We're here to stay for a long time.
Exactly. Well, dates are always challenging. I mean, today's...
You had a date once that was challenging, remember?
I think all my dates are challenging. You know, the producer can attest to that. You know, all dates are challenging, and you just got to do your best and try to get people here and play an entertaining brand of, soccer and indoor game, you know. So right there, you know, again, defensively, the ball can't happen.
Yeah, across, you
know, across the box, right?
Across the box. Joey should have probably dove on it and stopped the cross, and Elliott kind of left his man open. Short a man. Yeah. Doug, look at Ray's face right now. Ray Martinez, why did I come to America? Ray's dancing right now.
Ray saying, Kumo, that happened. Kumo. Saying, what happened? And Doug saying to him, how does that happen?
Yeah, 24-10. Harrisburg, congratulations on a goal from Harrisburg. We'll see the replay to see who scored that down. I hope you caught it. I didn't. We were talking about.
It came across. It was open. I think it was number five. Chris Hall?
Dave Cash was number five. I think Dave Cash.
I think it was number five.
Yes.
Yeah. So Dave Cash, it was a nice finish by him. But, again, he shouldn't get into that.
Yes, good play there. Harrisburg 24-10. Harrisburg still, you know, they're not giving up here. 3 minutes left in the game. Lance is up 24-10. Let's face it, the guys kind of took the break off a little bit. And that's the problem. When you start taking the break off, this is what coaches tell you. You take the break off because you don't want to embarrass the other team, but then you forget and you start taking the break off in other areas. And you can't do that because then you're going to give up bad goals and you're going to regret. Salas going around little too much. Gary Bount was open. Salas looking for another goal. He leads his team with goals. He wants one more.
Exactly. A little bit, again, I don't think Mauricio almost felt sorry for them. Didn't know whether to shoot or not, and should I shoot or not. And, you know, normally Mauricio gets a ball on his left foot and he shoots. Again, you're taking your gas off the pedal, and sometimes it affects you defensively when that happens. So, you know, again, two and a half minutes left. So just finish the game properly. Enrique had the ball there, and that's smart.
It's classy, Just play it back. You know, it's 2 minutes left, guys.
Just play it. Use your teammates. Pass the ball back and forth. Possess the ball. You know, in this game, you can possess for a minute and a half, 2 minutes.
And I think the fans appreciate that the Lancers are doing that.
Yes.
I mean, they've seen this happen against us for years. And Harrisburg's a great organization. Great people running it. Great coach, Tariq. And
Tariq Walker. Yeah. Tariq a Walker's lot of great things about him.
A great indoor player in his day.
Yeah.
And does a good job. It's just, you know, like you got a lot of first-year indoor players that are learning this game, but you can see the conference level and how well they play, and they're just a few players away. And here comes Andrew Hoxie, the big smooth, with Val Teixeira. Val so fast back on him. Hoxie kind of lost the ball. Hoxie, just don't get hurt, buddy. It's not worth it.
Not worth it. Just pass it back. Get rid of the ball. You know, kill the ball, get rid of it. No, nobody got hurt today, I don't believe. You know, just kill the game. Don't take unnecessary fouls if you don't have to.
Yep.
You know, don't over-dribble. Get out, rest, regroup, and play again on Thursday. We got a game in 4 days. So
Thursday's going to be another big game here, important game. Playoff run. Hopefully we get to see, now that we officially made the playoffs, maybe we'll see some players that we haven't seen in a while. Salas off the bar. Perez with possible his fourth goal off of Salas. The ball is still live here in Rochester. Salas wants one more goal, Mauricio Salas.
You can just tell. When he misses, he gets angry. Then he just wants to shoot.
Yes.
You know, so it's the competitor in him, you know, and this should go to Mauricio right away if you shoot, you know, and score. I mean, that's the right play. You know, it's unselfish play by Perez. Very good.
Mauricio Salas with the goal. That beautiful lady on the screen, if you're watching, is my beautiful wife, Linda. Happy Valentine's Day, baby.
One question. How does that happen?
She gets her looks from her uncle. He's a plastic surgeon.
It makes no sense whatsoever how that happens.
When I dated my wife back in the day, I was too cool to wear glasses, and they hadn't invented contacts yet.
Were you on an island?
Yes.
Just you?
Yes, just me and her.
There's no explanation for it. But anyway,
look at Mauricio Salas, thanking the crowd, 26-10.
And he knows, as soon as he shot it. He knows, do I really have to do this?
There's my son Sal on the screen right now. Soccer fans, we have fun here in Rochester, New York, and our great producer, John Catalano, it's a family. We've been doing this for many, many years. John and I have been together back in the day with the Rhinos, and John has since propelled his career. He does the Amherst of the AHL, the Nighthawks, the Razor Sharks, the NNL team, the Rattlers.
The Rattlers outside, right?
Does a lot of great things. He does a lot of great things. Speaking of the Razor Sharks, a shout out to Dr. Seb in Chicago, who is a big indoor soccer fan who watches the Mustangs and is listening and watching this broadcast right now, who owns the Razor Sharks. But anyway, Johnny's career went to the next level. He's doing all these sports, and I get called in when nobody else wants to do something.
You know, exactly.
They asked like six or seven other people to do the broadcast tonight. They wouldn't do it, and now I'm here.
Exactly. On a serious note, you know, we make fun of him all the time, but he's the best producer in town. So, you know, kudos to Johnny, and thank you for all your help, brother.
Rochester's 26 points is a season high. Previous high was 25 versus the Detroit Wazaflow on January 10th. So two games this year, we were over 25 points. And yes, most points this season. The fans are still dancing, having a good time. And the Lancers are still shooting. Joey Tavernese with a goal.
Yeah, that was... It's called garbage time.
Yeah, know? Joey didn't even want that goal. He's going to celebrate. No, it's not even cool. I shouldn't have got it. I had chances earlier in the game to score, and I didn't. I should have. But Joey, 28-10. That is definitely a season high now, 28 points for the Lancers.
Exactly.
I'm sorry for the Harrisburg Heat fans. Again, we have been there. I feel for you. I understand how it is.
Yeah.
You have a building team. You have a great team, a lot of great young players, and they will only improve. And that long bus ride in a storm, when it takes 4 or 5 hours longer than it should, does not help the legs.
But again, we've been there before. You know how that feels. And, you know, kudos to their effort. It's very difficult. You know, but what do you, you know, you're in front of the net. Are you supposed to miss on purpose?
Yeah.
You know, it's a tough, great game for the Lancers, though.
That's at the end of the game. The Lancers win it 28-10 over the Harrisburg Heats. Your Rochester Lancers are officially in the 2014-15 MASL Major Arena Soccer League playoffs. Thank you, Doug Miller. Thank you, Lancer players. Thank you, fans. I am excited as one of the owners of this franchise. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. You know, it's been a tough season with, you know, we had a tough spell there, 5 or 6 games in a row that we lost. So we're building, and now we got to build and focus. We know who we're playing in the playoffs. We know them. They know us.
Syracuse.
It's a matter of executing, and made the best team win. And kudos to the players. You know, great stuff.
Well, the players are in the middle of the field thanking the fans right now. And the person they hired to replace me, the beautiful Brooke, looks like she's looking to interview Mauricio Salas. Her first ever interview as a host of this broadcast. We may keep her on, Dom. I don't think Catalano wants to be part of this broadcast ever again.
I just got a thought in my mind. You know the Snickers commercial where somebody bites into a chocolate bar and they turn into somebody nice? I think you just turned into Brooke.
The beautiful Brooke.
You know, I got to get you a Snickers.
Let's
so much, soccer fans, for coming out in a snowstorm. What an amazing game to come see. Blue Rock Energy player of the game right here, Mauricio Salas. How does it feel to clinch the playoffs?
Yeah, thanks fans for coming one more time. And I don't know what to say. It brings tears to my eyes. I don't care if the league change. It's been 2 seasons we don't make the playoffs. We lost badly yesterday. But today, right now I have tears in my eyes because we are in the playoffs again. And that's all what matters.
Awesome. We clinched the playoffs today with a huge comeback game from yesterday. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Next we have Doug Miller. Congratulations on an awesome game. How does it feel to finally clinch the playoffs? And being a first-year coach for you, what does that mean to you?
Well, you know, as I told the guys in the locker room, today it's not, you know, that we will win. It's how we're going to win. And we won with a bit of class, a bit of nastiness, a bit of quality in scoring goals. But now the focus is five games to an MASL championship, and that's our focus. It's going to go Syracuse, Baltimore, maybe Missouri, and then San Diego, and that's what our focus is.
Yes, we are. We're focused and determined for the Mission Championship. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, next we have Rich Randall here, the president of the Rochester Lancers. What does it mean to you as a president to have our first playoff game in two seasons?
Being here since day one in 2011, the inception of this team, a lot of these fans were there since day one, and they've been passionate and have supported us since day one. So thank you, and thank you all for braving the snow and coming out to support the team. And March 5th, write it in your calendar. March 5th, we'll be hosting Syracuse because we clinched today right here at the Big House, 7 o'clock, rlancers.com. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Drive home safe, everyone, and have a great weekend.
Wow, the beautiful Brooke. She did a good job in her first ever interview here. Well, I mean, they said it. Doug Miller said it. We're in the playoffs. This is important. But Doug predicted they're going to beat Syracuse. They're going to beat Baltimore and on to hopefully San Diego. Soccer fans, on behalf of Dom Vieira, Dom, you did a great, great job, by the way.
Really, thank you. It was a lot of fun. Learned a lot. And when's Joe coming back?
Joe will be back next week, Joe Giuliano. On behalf of our producer, John Catalano, and this great, great production team here, have yourself a great, great soccer weekend. And if you can, feel it, baby. Feel the kick. And we'll be back on Fickle 93.3 FM soon.